Hello, trader. It's great to be back with you to tackle some trading challenges. Imagine this. There will always be support and resistance levels surrounding price movement, like channels guiding the market's flow, helping you stay in tune with price action. After some time researching, we've developed a product called PANA Kanal. So what's special about it? Let's dive in and find out. First, the core of PANA Kanal is the dynamic support and resistance zones that move with the price. They help in identifying trends and determining suitable trading signals, and they merge into a ribbon. What makes this ribbon special is that it's constructed from Fibonacci levels and average true range, so it not only provides trend direction, but also reliable dynamic support and resistance zones. When the indicator identifies that the market is in an uptrend, the ribbons will display in green and appear below the price, acting as support levels that move with the price. Since they use the average true range formula, they will adjust when significant volatility is detected in price action. This enhances the reliability of the uptrend and allows for quick responses when the price pulls back against the main trend. Conversely, when the market enters a downtrend, the ribbons will adjust to appear above the price, acting as resistance levels that move with the price, quickly detecting price volatility. At this point, they will turn pink. In addition, the indicator features a main plot line that runs around the price, changing color based on the price trend. This plot line plays a significant role, which we will connect to later. The indicator can also help you identify when the market is moving sideways. When the ribbons flatten out for an extended period, you can understand that the market is trending sideways, and the momentum for either an increase or decrease is fading. Not only that, but this indicator also provides levels that help you assess the market structure. Through the market structure that PANA Kanal offers, you can gauge the strength of the trend. How? Pay attention to these levels. In a strong downtrend, the market consistently breaks previous lows, which are the levels formed by those lows. Conversely, in a strong uptrend, the price continually breaks previous highs to keep rising. By using the indicator, when the price consistently surpasses the levels formed by those highs, you can identify whether the trend is strongly upward. Next, after confirming the stages in a trend, we will continue to identify trading signals, specifically the pullback and breakout signals. These two signals in this indicator will be a bit more special than the typical pullback and breakout signals that have appeared before. First is the pullback signal. The special point about this pullback signal is that the algorithm processes it to appear only once during a trend, and you can fully adjust the range for this signal to emerge from the moment the trend begins. When you customize this first pullback signal to appear close to the start of the trend, it will have a high degree of reliability. As you know, the first pullback signal in a trend is more significant than all subsequent pullback signals, especially since you can adjust the range for it to appear. This uniqueness will benefit traders who prefer to hold positions longer to achieve higher profits, allowing you to take control of your position in a trend. Particularly if you don't want other trading signals to cause confusion during your trading process, this is the ideal option for you. Next is the breakout signal, which is when the main plot performs its function. For the breakout signal in a downtrend, when the price moves up and cuts below this plot, the breakout signal will be proposed. However, this applies only to the first breakout signal in a trend. From the second breakout signal onwards, this breakout will need to go through two filters to be established. For the second breakout signal in a downtrend, the price needs to retest the dynamic resistance area and then cut below the main plot for the breakout signal to form. This way, the second breakout signal and beyond will be more reliable because, after entering the resistance zone, if the selling pressure is strong enough, it must cut through the main plot, indicating the strength of the selling force. Similarly, in an uptrend, the first breakout signal occurs when the price dips below the main plot and then cuts back above it. From the second breakout signal onwards, the price needs to return to the dynamic support area and then cut back above the main plot for the breakout signal to form. This combination ensures that you don't miss signals in a trend while also securing good positions. Not only does this indicator provide trends and signals, but it also offers features to help you manage your trades better, such as suggesting stop target points and trailing stops. First, there's the trailing stop line, which is a prominent plot line at the dynamic support and resistance levels, and it will move along with these support and resistance levels. To fully leverage the strength that a trend offers, you can move your stop when the trailing stop flattens out. As mentioned earlier, when the ribbons and the trailing stop are flat, it indicates that the market is showing signs of moving sideways, or that buying or selling pressure has stalled. Therefore, when you notice a flattening, we will move the stop to minimize risk and protect the profits we have earned. Next, we will actively take profits based on the target levels suggested by the indicator. First, focus on the green and red levels on the chart. These are the target levels that the indicator proposes for you to set targets with a risk-to-reward ratio designed to be nearly 1-1. Typically, the first breakout or pullback signals will have a higher win rate, so place your stop at the nearest dynamic support level and set your target at the first suggested target level. Next, for subsequent trades, set your targets at previous highs or lows based on the levels formed by the indicator on the chart, and adjust your targets dynamically at the trailing stop or at the nearest dynamic support and resistance areas that you prefer. Finally, you can move your stop based on the nearest support and resistance levels to take advantage of the strength the trend provides and open new trades more flexibly. This way, you will protect your profits and be able to implement better scalping strategies. Moving your stop to the nearest support areas will help you close trades early and flexibly in response to market fluctuations, especially if you're feeling anxious. Thus, we have introduced the entire mechanism and how PANA Kanal works. I hope you like it, and if you need any support, not just related to the product, but anything related to trading, feel free to reach out to us so we can assist you right away. Wishing you an effective trading day and see you next time. Thank you for watching the video. If you enjoyed the video, please like, subscribe, and hit the bell next to it to receive notifications about the latest videos from ninZa.co. Thank you very much.